All right, you got something nice in the mail? It is the motherboard for the ZBook. We can now complete the repair. Both motherboards, the old ones, were both PCH chip shorted. Let's see if we can get this going. Apparently it's a tested working condition. We don't know until we do it. Put it back. I've got two laptops here. So we've got two big boxes of skeletons of this computer. Let's see if we're going to be able to put it all back together nicely. Yeah, that's right. Let's see what we can do. So I suspect this is what may have caused the problem. This was put into a slot where it's supposed to be carrying the 4G memory, 4G modem. Okay. So stickers we don't need. Right, the stickers can get out of the way. Okay, we'll need this. Daughter board, do we need one or does this come with one? So this will go. Probably like this. Yep. So we'll keep this. This one is good condition. Okay, no problem. Put this back later. More stickers. We don't need. Yes, we need. Hinge cover we need. We got two of these. More stickers, it can go. They're both the same. This one is a bit of a liquid spill or something. Alright, we'll keep that one out. Keep this one. And which one is less scratched? This looks better. Okay. That's the smart card reader. We'll need that, need that. Now, fingerprint reader, it seems to be too much red, like red a lot. They've used it a lot. Maybe we can use the other one. Okay. Okay. That's upgraded RAM. We might actually use these ones. And in terms of the case, I would like to use the other one, the other case. Okay. Now we'll need a CPU, of course, and the GPU. Have a look at the CPU, see if they're the same. Two LA437, two, okay, no, they're different. Let me double check. Okay, i7 4th generation, 4800 MQ, so SR15L, and this one is SR. SR1PT. So this is a i7-4900 and this is a i7-4800. Double check. 4900, 4800. No. Here. This is 4800, so we're not going to use this one. We're going to use the 4900. So let's let me check that. Okay, let's continue along. So what we should do is clean the CPU first. It's going to be a little mess to put it all back. What we can do? Okay. Okay, let's do the CPU first. Okay. So that's the battery connector. Now we do need to put extra RAM, so the all the remaining RAM. So, okay. 1, 2, 3. So this has a backlit keyboard. We'll look at that later. One terabyte SSD. Maybe the drive. It's gonna be fun to put all this back together. That will go here.
Okay.
We got our NVIDIA Quadro. Okay. Not sure if I need that screw now or later. So by the looks of it, I just can't remember if there was a screw there or not. Okay, there is. It is the... It's a thick one. Yep. Okay. All right, so put the CPU in first, clean here too. Thank you. Hey, yeah, I did, but I don't know, I need to wash it or something. Yeah, okay. Let's give that a clean too. Okay, let's clean this one. Oh, that should be fine. Okay. Okay, so far, so good. Okay, that's better. Flush. Okay. Thank you. Okay, fan is good. One second. So, we got these expansion cards. So this is for USB and audio. So we need, how many screws here? Probably four. So many screws. Formula, okay. Alright. Just check which one is the formula. No, that's right, okay. Just make sure. There we go. That was sticking out. All right, so the battery goes here. no problem. Okay. The motherboard is nice and secure. Let's do the smart card. Now that one may be together with this guy. And in that case, must be a very small one. No, okay. That is an interesting one. These are too small. Okay, we're going to ignore that one. As it serves no purpose. No. There isn't actually one there. It's coming, it's pushing out the edge. Okay. Cool. So far, so good. Two daughter boards in, four RAMs in, GPU, CPU. Okay. So this will go like this, but at a later time. And one of these will kick in like this. I think this goes in when we put the screen on there. We shouldn't forget we have a speaker here. Now we don't know if this is how it's supposed to go. But I do know one of the screws is long and one of them is short. Okay. Now there is a hole on the bottom of this, which is interesting, which means screw goes from the bottom up. Right. And but this side, no. So means, oh yeah. Yeah, okay, so we can only put, interesting, one long on one side, one small on the other side. Yep, by far same size. Yep. Okay, and the other screws come from the bottom. Okay. We should actually test the unit at this stage before we, you know, take this all the way. Okay. Let's try and turn this unit on. Let's get power. Turning on, and we have 0 HP logo. Isn't this good news? Okay, so that's fine. So far, whatever we're doing is good. Let's continue along. I would rather this cable not touch the hot. Yeah, there we go. That's how it should be. Nice. We'll have a screw going down Okay, that's better. It's looking pretty good. I can see some screw holes, but they're for the other side or top panel, etc. Okay, this is good so far. Now let's put these antenna wires in. Alright, it's 6:30, time to leave it here. We'll continue again tomorrow. Alright, let's finish up the HP. It's a new day. See where we're at. Okay, that's gonna be grounding. I remember I was doing these cables last time. These Wi-Fi cables. They need to be routed in a certain way so it doesn't get in the way. Looks nice and flush. Okay, fan connector, that's in, GPU in, that looks nice there. The grounding cable will be nice going through the hole. Screws will come from the bottom. I think we're doing good. Now this is the top shelf we're gonna use. That's in there, that's in there. Keyboard and the LED connector will go there, that will go there. You just want to make sure we got everything properly. Okay, so we're missing something on the left side, which I suspect is this one. Ah, okay, good, good eye. So the screw must come out. This should go in first. Yep. Okay, that's a bit of a dilemma. Okay, looks like it's supposed to be maybe a longer screw. Let me see. Okay, now that's flush. Yeah, that's good. That's better. That sits perfectly flush. Good, that's in. This one's going to be a challenge. There's a little bit of problem with this one. Okay, we may need different tweezers. Okay. Thank you. Now that is the connection for, I suspect, the fingerprint. Let me check. Yes, it is, but there's also another problem. There should be a cable coming from the trackpad, which is not coming unless it's hidden. Okay, so this is not good. Cable is stuck. Okay, that's better. Very interesting. All right. I see that screw there is for the keyboard. Okay. So far, so good. Now, this is going to be tricky. Okay. Now we can do another test. The way we'll do this test, I do want to connect a hard drive. Oh god, okay, all of them are gonna fall. No, we don't want you to fall. Come on, mate. Okay. Power on, see if you can get into BIOS. Yeah, beautiful. Nice. Yeah, the keyboard is working fine. Trackpad is working. So, we can safely assume, I didn't check the RAM, let me check the RAM. Gigabyte RAM, beautiful. Okay, sweet. Yeah, that's also working. Okay, now we can gently close this. Now the rest of the work will be done around here. I'd also like to fix the back. So the way this goes, it's supposed to go like that, but we need, as you can see, screws here. So let's see what kind of screws we need. These are important. They provide support to the hinge. Very, very important. Okay, I doubt it's these ones. These are for the bottom. Bit of a mystery. And same thing on this side. Nice. And same on the other side. Now we can put this flash face on top. Nice. It looks all nice and neat. And if I remember, they had a different style screw. I think it's these thin ones, let me see. Yep, that's right. Two more. Nice. So yeah, what they had previously done was put this SSD into this slot here. Or here? Here. Yeah, here. Which was actually a problem. It should have actually gone here. Yeah, that's the SSD slot. This is not for M2. Yeah. So if you want to use M2, you put it in an adapter, you put it here. Yeah. Okay. So now let's do the final cabling. Okay, by the looks of it, that does look like an SSD slot. But putting this here, why will it kill the motherboard? And that's what's happened. So the PCH died when this was installed. Why? I really don't know. Now these are the long ones. Nearly there. All right, so okay, that's fine. Yep. Pretty much done, I think. Do we have any screws under here? Nope, it's all done. Yep. Just looking around the leftover parts, therefore the other computer. Not sure if you received another caddy, I'm not sure. Which I don't see. Okay, we don't have. What I want to do is test the M SATA adapter using my adapter here. So this simply should go in here. Just for temporarily. Put a screw here. We'll set the boot mode in a correct way so that when the client gets their computer back, put their own hard drive, whatever, they should be able to boot off that port. There may be an operating system on the other SSD, no idea. So let's go. F10, have a look in the BIOS boot options. Okay. Boot options, okay. So MSATA, hard drive, boot manager, UOS boot manager, okay. So it's gonna boot off the MSATA drive first, I think. Let's do F9, bring up the boot menu. Booting of something, I don't know what. Okay. All right, I'll just be right back. Okay, so one thing I've confirmed is when you boot the computer, okay, so this note, this message is for the owner of the computer. So when you have both hard drives hooked up, mSATA and the crucial 1 terabyte SSD, by default it will boot off the mSATA. Now you can verify that if you turn the computer on, press F9 key, will bring up the boot device menu options. Now OS boot manager is mSATA, notebook hard drive is mSATA, and notebook hard drive 2 is the crucial SSD. So if I, by default it's going to boot off the mSATA, and you will see Windows 10 load up super quick. And we'll see the client's name. Okay, so shut down. Now if I want to boot off the crucial 1 terabyte SSD, turn it on, F9 key again. And if I was to choose this time hard drive 2, and you will see the other window is loading. As you can see, owner account, different. Simple as that. Okay. Shut the computer down. Beautiful. Alright, so this job is finally complete. We could not repair the board, unfortunately, beyond, I just don't know if you replace that ice PCH chip, will there be more problems? We don't know. This is a much better fix. Maybe one day we will actually do a job of putting a PCH chip. So this guy is good. Thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next one.
Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to support this channel.